السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم بارك لنا في جمعنا هذا واجعله تجمعا مرحوما، واجعل تفرقنا من بعده تفرقا معصوما، ولا تجعل فينا ولا بيننا شقيا ولا محروما. آمين يا رب العالمين. Allah put barakah in this gathering and make us from the people who will be told قوموا مغفورا لكم قد بدلت سيئاتكم حسنات. آمين يا رب العالمين. Tonight inshallah ta'ala we have one of the great names of Allah Azza wa Jal, a name that we all should study and understand and use in our dua inshallah, and that name is Ismullah Azza wa Jal Ash-Shakur. Ismullah Ash-Shakur. Linguistically, shukr means to increase, appreciate, and recognize good. And Shakur in Arabic is used as well to describe an animal that is fed with little but gives much back. And when it comes to Allah Azza wa Jal, the name Ash-Shakur is the one who is most, who appreciate the most appreciative, the most grateful, and the rewarder of good work. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the name of Allah Ash-Shakur is mentioned in the Quran how many times? It's hard to guess, yani, but 0 to 10. 4 times. Name Ash-Shakur is mentioned 4 times. Let me mention, you know what, since all four, I'll mention all four of them. In Surah Fatir, لِيُوَفِّيَهُمْ أُجُورَهُمْ وَيَزِيدَهُمْ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ إِنَّهُ غَفُورٌ شَكُورٌ. And in also in Surah Fatir, Inna Rabbana Laghafurun Shakur. And in Surah At-Taghabun, Wayaghfir Lakum Wallahu Shakurun Halim. And there is one more in the Shura. Waman yaqtarif hasanatan nazid lahu fiha husna, Inna Allaha Ghafurun Shakur. And if we notice, in 3 out of 4, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put this name Shakur with Ghafoor. Subhanallah. Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the name Ash-Shakur, is the one who gives abundantly for a little work. This is what Ash-Shakur means. He gives a lot for a little work. You get up in Laylatul Qadr sincerely, imanan wa ihtisaban, all your sins are forgiven and it's worth over 83 years of ibadah. Is this for real? You fast on Ashura, you get 1 year of sins forgiven. This is Ash-Shakur. You fast on Arafah, you get 2 years forgiven. This is Ash-Shakur. Small thing, small action, a lot of appreciation and a lot of reward. Even in general, like I mentioned before, if I live 60, 70 years and I was a good abd, righteous abd, if you want to be just, then you send me to Jannah 50, 60 years, right? You were good for 50, we give you Jannah for 50. This is just, we'll throw another 50. Buy 50, get 50 free. Huh? 100. But to be forever, Ash-Shakur is the only one who does something like this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Ash-Shakur. Now, قال البيهقي رحمه الله, listen to this, هو الذي يشكر اليسير من الطاعة فيثيب عليه الكثير من الثواب. He is the one who give a little of ta'a, a lot of reward. A little of ta'a, a lot of reward. This hadith, this name is mentioned in a form, in a hadith, in a different form. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, we all know the hadith, بينما رجل يمشي بطريق وجد غصن شوك على الطريق فأخره فشكره الله فغفر له. A man was walking on the street and he saw a branch laying on the street that could harm people, could maybe be an obstacle for people to move, so he removed it. It says the hadith, he removed it, فَشَكَرَ اللَّهُ لَهُ. Here, if we translate it linguistically, it means like Allah thanked him. But no, this is not the way. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala شَكَرَ لَهُ, exactly. He rewarded him, and the hadith did not stop here. فَغَفَرَ لَهُ. Excellent. So by this small action of removing something on the street, the reward was all your sins are forgiven. You say, Alhamdulillah, الذي أطعمنا هذا, أطعمني هذا, ورزقني من غير حول مني ولا قوة. After I eat, what happened? All your sins are forgiven. If I finish the salat, Subhanallah 33, Alhamdulillah 33, Allahu Akbar 33, and I finish it with La ilaha illallah, وحده لا شريك له, له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير, غفرت ذنوبه ولو كانت مثل زبد البحر. All the sins are forgiven, even if they were as much as the foam of the sea. Who does that? Ash-Shakur. Because this is really, for us, especially in these days, this is unbelievable. Yani, from Salat to Salat, sins are forgiven. From Jum'ah to Jum'ah, sins are forgiven. From Ramadan to Ramadan, sins are forgiven. From Umrah to Umrah, sins are forgiven. Allahu Akbar. This is Ash-Shakur, Azza wa Jal. The one who multiplies, now listen to this, if you do the calculation according to this, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala multiplies every hasana with 10 and up to 700, okay? And the sayyi'ah is only one. And after all this, you see someone going to hell. You do the calculation. I did 10 hasana. Okay? Let's say it was multiplied 700. That's 7,000, right? And if I still go to hell, how many sayyad do I have? The point is, because this question comes a lot, especially from non-Muslims, and sometimes from Muslims also. How come Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so forgiving and so merciful and He still throw people in hell? طيب يا حبيبي, is he, if He multiplies the hasana by 700 and the sayyat is only one, and this guy, his sayyat is still more than his hasanat, wallahi, he deserves to go to hell. Right or not? And you can imagine how many sayyat this man or this person have. This is the shakur subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who multiplies. From his shukr, and this is probably the most important thing tonight, listen carefully, Akhwan. From his shukr is that if you leave something for his sake, he will replace it with something better. Logically, I'm supposed to leave the bad things. This is normal. As a Muslim, as a believer, I'm supposed to stay away from this haram, that job, that whatever is haram. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِذَا تَرَكْتْ شَيْءٍ لِلَّهِ, if you leave something for the sake of Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will replace it with something much better. Think about it. Think about it on a daily, on a dunya scale. If I work for a king, and he told me, I want to go somewhere, and then he noticed that it's my day off. And I said, you know what? I'm not gonna take the day off. Sure, Your Majesty, no problem. I'll do it. You think he's gonna just let it go? He's gonna do something very nice to me, right? Because I know I did this favor to a king. I did this action to a king. So you think the King of Kings, when you leave something for his sake, how he's gonna treat you? Allah, ya akhwan, because you see, when we are especially, when we are involved in a job that is haram, the shaitan comes from every aspect. Like Allah said, يَعِدُكُمُ الْفَقْرِ. He promised us, you're gonna leave this job? Are you crazy? $150,000, $200,000 a year, there are people making 30. Are you crazy? إِنَّ اللَّهَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. What's the big deal? It's not a big sin. It's just a shubha. Maybe small, not major. What's the big deal? Alhamdulillah, you pray, you fast, you donate to the masjid. You give a lot of stuff. And he starts reminding you of every hasana in order not to leave that job. And he will never let this hadith come to mind, that if you leave something for the sake of Allah, Allah will replace it. Sheikh Tantawi, rahimahullah, he said a beautiful story, inshallah. We'll mention the story quickly. He said there was a very, very, very righteous man who used to be a student of knowledge. And he was extremely poor, very poor. And one time, things were not working. He did not find a job for a couple of days. He was 2 days without any food, no food. And he's sitting with the sheikh. He hardly can understand what the sheikh is saying out of hunger. So the third day, still no food, you know. So he said, you know, I'm starving. I have to get something at least to make me able to survive. So in those days, you know, from the house, you could walk on the roof from one house, from one building to another. You remember in the old days. So he looked in the next door. He saw that next door they having there's a food on the oven, on the stove. So he went, long story short, and he got there. He opened out of hunger. He did not even notice that the eggplant is even boiling. So he took a bite. And then he recognized, La ilaha illallah, I am a student of knowledge. I am a person that fear Allah. How could I do something like this? He put it back. He closed it and went back and make a lot of istighfar. How could I do something like this? And time for the class came. So he went down to sit down with the teacher, and he is famished, literally starving. As the sheikh is giving the class, a woman came and whispered something in the ears of the sheikh. So the sheikh looked at the crowd. He looked at him. You want to get married? He said, yeah, sheikh, I don't have a piece of bread. I don't have food to support myself. How can I support somebody with me? Do you want to get married? He said, yes, yeah, sheikh. What a kelma. Yes, yeah, sheikh. He said, this woman who just whispered in my ear, her husband died, her iddah is finished, and she doesn't want to be living alone. She wants to be protected by a man, righteous man, and she asked me, and I chose you. Do you accept? Here's something, give her as her mahar. He said, I accept. He went, the same day, he went to her house. This woman inherited the house from her husband. First thing, before he thinks about something else, the guy is hungry. So he went. Which house was it? The eggplant house. She opened the pot and she saw that there is one eggplant bitten. She said, Subhanallah, who ate this eggplant? So when he saw that, he started crying. And he told her the story. She said, because you feared Allah and you left something for the sake of Allah, Allah did not replace you with eggplant. He replaced you with the eggplant and with the owner of the eggplant and the house of the owner of the eggplant. Subhanallah. And ya akhwan, and Sheikh Tantawi, he was saying the story, it's 100% took place. So it's all about true iman. What is it for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to replace you with something better, knowing that you left something for His sake? You left a sin that you are so attached to. You know what? I'm not going to look at these things anymore. Astaghfirullah, that's it. I'm done with that stuff. I'm not going to listen to that stuff anymore. I leave it for your sake, Ya Allah. That's it, I'm done. Subhanallah, even though we are supposed to, Allah will reward us. This is the Shakur. You know, and another quick example, Sahaba left Mecca for the sake of Allah to Medina. Allah gave him the word. They conquered the word. Subhanallah. Yusuf alayhi salam left the beautiful, attractive wife of the Aziz. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replaced him by making him the Amir in Masr. Now, what is the difference between hamd and shukr? What's the difference between hamd and shukr? Sometimes hamd could be the general and the shukr particular, and sometimes the shukr is the general and the hamd is particular. How come? The hamd is general when it comes because the hamd is ala sarra wa dharra. The hamd, you say alhamdulillah if something good happened, and you say alhamdulillah ala kulli hal if something bad happened, right? So alhamdulillah, alhamd for both. Ash-shukr only for good. Ash-shukr only for good. Now this is where alhamd is more general than the shukr. Where is the shukr is more general than the hamd? The hamd is only by the tongue. The shukr is by the tongue and by the heart and by the actions. The shukr, اعملوا آل داود شكرا. When you pray, you are shakur. When you fast, you are shakur. When you give sadaqat, you are shakur. When you perform qiyam, you are shakur. You are showing gratitude to Allah Azza wa Jal. This is how we show, this is how we become abd shakur. If someone asks me or asks you, ya akhi, هل أنت عبد شكور? Are you a shakur? Check. Where are you from the ta'at of Allah Azza wa Jal? Where are you from the siyam of the nafila? The siyam, the optional siyam. Where are you from the qiyam? Where are you from the sadaqat? Where are you from birr al-walidain? Where are you from helping others, supporting others? Where are you when you see someone in need of help and money? Where are you to provide some financial help? Where are you when you hear someone is sick? Where are you? This is how you find out if you are Abid Shakur or not. Nuh alayhi salam, innahu kana abdan shakura. Now, how can we become Abid Shakur? First, like I mentioned, by doing a lot of optional ibadat. Besides the fard, we have no discussion. The fard is fard, it's a must. But to do extra, this is when you become shakur. Second, to remember that Allah said, وَسَيَجْزِ اللَّهُ الشَّاكِرِينَ. You know, when you go visit somebody and someone asks you, what should I take with me as a gift? There's a saying in Arabic, you know, they say, you know, you give your qima, you give what you are worth. You don't give, because this is a poor guy, I take him, $5 cake, and because this guy is a rich guy, I take him a $50 cake. You give what you are. Doesn't matter where you're going. And this is something on the side quickly. Please, when you go into people's homes, enter blind and leave dumb. You enter people's homes blind, and you leave the houses dumb. You, whatever you see inside, you did not see anything, you're blind. And whatever you saw inside, you do not talk about it when you leave. Okay? So, when you remember, وَسَيَجْزِ اللَّهُ الشَّاكِرِينَ, Allah is gonna give the jaza to the one who is grateful, to the shakirin. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is gonna give something that befits His majesty. Just like when you go somewhere, you give something that befits you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, وَسَيَجْزِ اللَّهُ الشَّاكِرِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you with something immense. قال موسى عليه السلام, يَا رَبِّ إِنْ أَنَا بَلَّغْتْ رِسَالَتَكْ فَمِنْ عِنْدِكْ وَإِنْ أَنَا صَلَّيْتْ فَمِنْ عِنْدِكْ وَأَنَا فَعَلْتْ كَذَا وَكَذَا فَمِنْ عِنْدِكْ فَكَيْفَ أَشْكُرُكْ. قال الآن شكرتني. Musa alayhi salam, he said, Ya Allah, if I became a prophet, it's because of you. And if I prayed, it's because of you. And if I fasted, it's because of you. And if I did anything, it's because of you. So how can I thank you? He said, now you thanked me. Al-ajz an shukr, tamam al-shukr. Al-ajz an shukr, huwa tamam al-shukr. When you feel like you cannot thank someone enough, that is the perfect shukr. You know, when you think about what Allah blessed us with, Wallahi, if I give everybody a piece of paper and say, Ya Akhi, please start writing the na'am that you have. Fajr will go, Tuhr will go, we will miss Jum'ah, Asr will go, and we're still writing, Wallahi. And what do we do in return? We still miss salawat. We still miss salawat. We still lie sometimes. We still backbite, and we still do things that are upsetting to Allah Azza wa Jal, that will ruin our life. Subhanallah. And He has asbagha alaykum ni'amahu zahiratan wa batina. He has given us so much ni'am. So much ni'am. Now, Allah Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, He told us one of the ways to become a shakur is not to belittle any good deed. You know, since doing good deeds is a form of shukr, do not belittle the smile. Do not belittle if someone tells you, please intercede for me. Do not belittle anything. Everything counts with Allah Azza wa Jal. مَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ ذَرَّةٍ ذَرَّةٍ And the hadith, whomsoever spend the tamra, Allah will save it, it becomes a mountain. So you are not dealing with me. You're dealing with Allah Azza wa Jal. Smile, intercession, good word, salam, ya akhwan. Huh? This is so beautiful. This is a way to become a shakur. Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he told us, whoever relieves from a believer some grief to this pertaining to this word, Allah will relieve from him some grief pertaining to the akhirah. And whosoever conceal, ya akhwan, please, ya akhwan, I beg you for the sake of Allah, my brothers, my sisters, conceal your brother's faults. Hide his fault. Hide your sister's faults. Do not, when you see something, you cannot wait to tell everybody in the world. And I'm going to tell you something, don't tell anybody. Wallahi, fear Allah. Fear Allah. Hide your brother's faults. Hide your brother's faults. Allah will hide your faults on that day when you really need it. Subhanallah. And finally, one of the ways to become a shakur is not to expect anything in return. When you do a khidmah, when you do something to someone, do not wait for something in return. And this is going to be the topic. I'll be the khatib tomorrow, inshallah, the first khutbah. This is part of our khutbah tomorrow, is subhanallah, is not to expect something in return. How can we use this in dua? You know, one of my favorite dua in the Quran, like I mention all the time, there's no dua that is better than the dua of the Quran, because it's by Allah Himself. And one of my favorite dua in Surah Al-Ahqaf, Surah number 46, ayah number 15, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, we gave a khutbah about it, رَبِّ أَوْزِعْنِي أَنْ أَشْكُرَ نِعْمَتَكَ الَّتِي أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِ وعلى والدي وأن أعمل صالحا ترضاه وأصلح لي في ذريتي إني تبت إليك وإني من المسلمين. يا الله, help me to thank you for all the ni'am that you blessed me and you blessed my parents. And help me, ya Allah, to do righteous deeds that are pleasing to you. And ya Allah, make all my offsprings, not only my children, all my offsprings, Salihin. Ya Allah, I am a sinner, so I repent to you. And Ya Allah, I am from the Muslimin. Allahumma ij'alna min ash-shakirin. Allahumma ij'alna min ibadika ash-shakirin. Allahumma ij'alna min ibadika ash-shakirin. Allahumma waffiqna lima tuhibbu wa tarda. Allahumma waffiqna lima tuhibbu wa tarda. Rabbana hab lana min azwajina wa dhurriyyatina qurrata a'yun waj'alna lil muttaqina imama. Allahumma arina al-haqqa haqqan warzuqna ittiba'ahu wa arina al-batila batilan warzuqna ijtinabahu. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik, nashhadu an la ilaha illa أنت, نستغفرك ونتوب إليك. Please come early to Jum'ah tomorrow and can come to Fajr inshallah ta'ala at 6:30. جزاكم الله خير. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.